According to David Livingstone Ebiru, the Uganda National Bureau of Standards Executive Director, the Bureau is currently aiming at promoting voluntary compliance to quality standards. He was speaking on the sidelines of the commissioning of the state-of-the-art food and safety laboratory in Western Uganda.
We promote voluntary compliance to quality standards, especially by the manufacturers and the enterprises that are trying to put commodities on the market. This is very important because government is currently promoting what we call import substitution. For goodness sake, really, we are importing majority of things we can manufacture and produce within Uganda. So there is a lot of money we are spending in terms of importing these products from other countries, yet we can actually save that money and keep it into the country for other better economic activities.
With such infrastructure, the hope is that producers will no longer travel longer distances to confirm the standards of their products. Government is currently decentralizing UNBS services of certification, surveillance and testing to traditional regions of Western, Northern and Eastern.
So there was a bit of disincentive for people who are distant. Imagine coming from Arua, coming from Kisoro, coming from Kotido, up to Kampala. So I think indeed the low levels of compliance was partly responsible for accessibility of UNBS quality infrastructure, which was only based in Kampala.
We have over 10 countries supporting us and development agencies as well. The decentralization of labs is very critical in our work of trade facilitation because it brings services closer to the people. We have a laboratory already in Gulu to serve the northern region, in Bale to serve the eastern region, and here in Barra to serve the western region. So the decentralization of labs helps the communities, the businesses, to be able to check the quality of their produce. Without quality produce, you cannot be able to have competitive products.
Over 63,000 samples and 1,100 standards have been developed, over 12,000 equipment calibrated, and 26,000 market outlets inspected, and over 2.9 million equipment verified. Story by Aloysius Kasoma for the news.